I have to first ask you about the most pressing issue for markets, it seems, in the last couple of days is this price war between Russia and the Saudis and OPEC. How will this affect your business with the big drop in the ruble and you get such a big piece of your profits in that currency?
Well, good morning from my side and thanks for having me. I think it's an interesting question you're asking. We are just closing our fiscal year 2019 and of course we're looking forward to the next fiscal year. And of course the development of the oil prices and the ruble is something which is something we're looking at it very clearly. We are not have not so much exposure on oil prices. We are more on gas, and gas is not always coupled on gas prices. And of course, we have long-term contracts, and that have hedged our business. So we are expecting still an adjusted EBIT for this fiscal year between 750 million and 1 billion as an outlook. And of course, we will have this fiscal year as well a very reliable dividend payment coming up.
So is your assessment of what we saw in markets yesterday, Andreas, that this has, both on the oil price and on the ruble, this does not affect your 2020?
Well, I think we were looking into it. I think it's at the moment too early to raise any concerns. We have seen fluctuations in the ruble every year, actually. It's one-third of our business, but we have a very strong performance there, which have contributed last year to our excellent results as well. So from that point of view, I think we are studying the situation, but we are not completely concerned.
The price of natural gas has also come down significantly. And of course, you have higher pricing really helping your results. And that's one of the, I think, the key takeaways from your results. But how do you forecast gas prices? How do you forecast power prices going forward?
Well, I think for the gas prices, I think we expect that they will be under pressure, especially with what is going on in the last couple of days. And of course, if you look outside, I don't know how is the weather in London. Here in Düsseldorf, it's more feeling like spring. Winter was not really there. So that was definitely putting some pressure on gas. The storages are still full. So actually, the situation has not changed dramatically. There's a lot of gas available. LNG is coming from Asia to Europe. But I think that's a situation we can deal with. We forecast that we will need more gas, especially if the production in Europe is going significantly down and running. And so it's something which we have expected. Maybe it's coming a little bit earlier.
I'm here in Berlin, Andreas, and we have our own special climate. Although I don't feel like we had much of a winter either. It just rains and is gray every day. Nonetheless, we use a lot of gas. It's cheaper than coal, so we're using more gas than coal. How quickly do you expect that shift to happen across Germany?
But actually, it has already happened last year in summer as the carbon price was nearing the 30 euros mark per ton of CO2 and low gas prices. You have seen the switch from carbon to gas automatically, and you've seen it in our figures as well. This has contributed to our results last year quite significantly. So I think it's a proof point that the switch from coal to gas can happen driven by market trends if the carbon rate and the gas price is in the right box. And I think with the gas prices now coming down further and the CO2 prices are staying in a medium level, I think that's good for us and good for the gas business and for the generation. So I think you will see this coal exit a little bit accelerated in a way driven by the market.
Can I ask, in the context of commitments you've made around carbon neutrality and decarbonization, what is going to be the main focus of Uniper's growth strategy, given that push that you're making as a business towards being carbon neutral?
I think with the closing of the last year and an excellent result, one of the best years ever, and a raised dividend proposal, I think we set our course to an updated strategy. And for our European generation business, we had out a target that we will be 2035 carbon neutral. That means that probably we're still emitting carbon, but we will set it off with technology or other means. And the coal exit, which we are accepting and driving proactively, will help on that. But nevertheless, it's a switch to natural gas and LNG, It will be a switch to hydrogen partially. We will drive that. We have some experience with hydrogen. We're having already some bigger projects in transportation, chemical industry, and generation of hydrogen. And most of our assets, so the turbines itself, can take hydrogen. Of course, it needs some moderation, but I think we're on a good track. So we are definitely committed to ourselves. To 2035, we will be carbon neutral in Europe. The other parts of the business, the commodity business and international generation, of course, is a different chapter. And we are looking there as well what we can do.